Yeah, happy new year, everybody. It is time once again for the Blue Junkyard, the first junkyard of the year, right here on 22 West Radio at 22westmedia.com. I'm your host, Robert Junkyard Bob Eliff, and we got a great show planned for today because Jon Garner of the Golden Butter Revue is coming into the studio to talk about his brand new album, Cookin' at the Harp. And we're going to get into how Jon got into the blues, how he got into harmonica playing, and especially talk about this record. But without further ado, let's get into the first track from the Golden Butter Revue's Cookin' at the Harp album. Here's Don't Want No Woman, right here on 22 West Radio at 22westmedia.com.
No woman telling me what to do. I don't want no woman showing up telling me what to do. Said I'm grown now, darling. Baby, what's wrong with you? I don't want no woman telling me this and that. Thank you so very much.
Oh, yeah, and that was the Golden Butter Review with Don't Want No Woman from Cookin' at the Harp, kicking our show off. And in the studio with me, of course, is Jon Garner of the Golden Butter Review. Jon, how are you doing?
Doing good.
We were cracking up off air about some old comedians.
Fred Sanford.
So, let's start with this record. What was the inspiration for doing this live album?
Well, I always wanted to do a CD, and I've, frankly, I've been a little underserved, in my opinion, as far as the number of CDs I've played on. And so I thought, well, you know, I'll make my own. And the way that it became possible is that we started recording a lot of our gigs, and by getting Kai Michael in the band and Ron Revicchio, who's a fantastic drummer, it really put us, you know, we went from like a party band to like a serious, really good band. And so it's been kind of a fun project.
And where did the name Golden Butter Revue come from?
Well, I had another band, and to kind of change the personnel up a little bit, I had to come up with a new name. And I've always been a huge Paul Butterfield fan, especially the Butterfield Blues Band. And Golden Butter is the name of the Butterfield Blues Band's greatest hits album. So okay, that's where I got that.
Looking at your lineup, like you said, you got Kai Michael, who's also, as you told us off air, he's got his own band, Pink and Blue. And he's part of She Wears Black, right, with Shiva Fly and Stoney Garola and those guys. You got John Burton on guitar and backing vocals, who you mentioned you've been playing with for over 50 years now.
Yeah, since we were kids in high school.
Rick Rolfs on the bass and the vocals, and Ron Revicchio on drums. But you also got a number of special guests. How did all these special guests, like Mark Sells, Jesse Godoy, yeah, how did they all come about?
Well, that's kind of interesting, because I was contacted by Rick Snyder on behalf of the Orange County Blues Society a couple years ago to see if I wanted to come to this jam at Main Street in Yorba Linda. And I didn't know anything about the Orange County Blues Society, and I don't know how they found out about me, but so I said, sure, I'd like to come up and do that. It was a charity event for the flood victims of Houston. I said, but I'm going to be late because I'm playing in the Harp battle at the Orange County Fairgrounds. So he goes, okay. So I got there, and there were three sets to go. The first set was the Michael Mills Band, which Ron Revicchio is a fixture in, key player, and Jesse Godoy was in that band too. And so after their set, I introduced myself to Ron. I said, man, you're really a good drummer, you know, and real nice guy. Then the next set was Mark Sells, and it was the first time I'd ever heard him too. And so I met him, real nice guy, and we've been really good friends ever since, Mark and me. And then the last set, they put me up with Jaime Duran, who's a terrific guitar player too, and Miley. Everybody knows Miley. She's a wonderful girl singer. And I just had a ball, and it kind of just went from there.
Well, let's get into the next track on the album, and we'll talk a little bit more on how you got into the music. The next track on this brand new album, Cookin' at the Harp, is Don't You Lie to Me, which is a classic Hudson Whitaker song.
Tampa Red.
Yep, and it's been recorded by, you know, by guys like Albert King and so many various artists.
Our version is most closely aligned with Albert King, and this is the first time we ever tried it, but we had some serious firepower on this cut. So,
well, let's check it out right here on 22 West Radio at 22westmedia.com. The Golden Butter Review, Don't You Lie to Me.
Yeah.
you're here.
Oh, yeah, and that was the Golden Butter Revue with Don't You Lie to Me from Cookin at the Harp, their brand new self-released album. How did you get into the music?
I heard an album called Fresh Cream, and you guys have probably heard that too. Mm-hmm. And before that, I was listening to surf music, Paul Revere and the Raiders, stuff like that. Nothing wrong with that music. But when I heard Fresh Cream, and in particular their version of I'm So Glad with those rolling drums and Jack Bruce's vocals and beautiful guitar, I didn't know anything about music, but I thought, man, I'm going to become a musician. And it just so happened that there was harmonica on like three of the songs. And I figured, you know, I already played guitar a little bit, but I wasn't very good. And so I thought, well, you know, I can at least become like a half-assed musician a lot faster on one of those things. And from the beginning, I had a knack for always choosing the right harmonicas, you know, as far as the key goes. I never missed. And also, the way I taught myself how to play was I would learn every note of harmonica on a certain song. Like some of my early ones were Junior Wells' Early in the Morning. There was Help Me by Charlie Musselwhite, you know, and Love and Spoonful had one called Night Owl Blues, and there are a couple Steve Miller songs. So I would listen to these, and I would literally learn all the harp notes and play them from memory. And that's what taught me how to play clean single notes. And unless you are learning at the feet of the masters, I didn't have that opportunity. I would recommend that that's how you learn to play. And in fact, I'm going to do a video about how to use a guitar to instantly pick the right key of harmonica. Because not everybody knows how to. There's some good harp players that I know that have to fumble around, you know?
Yeah.
So that was it. And then they had, on the liner notes on Fresh Cream, they mentioned John Mayall and some other stuff. So I bought John Mayall albums, and he mentioned, you know, Peter Green was on there, and he mentioned these other guys like, you know, some of the Chicago blues greats. And then that's how it all spread. And it wasn't too long before I heard the first Butterfield Blues Band album. And I, you know, with Bloomfield just smoking on the guitar. And I just thought, man, this is really something right here. So that's how I got started.
And I got to mention, too, because I don't know if you've seen it, John, but there's a great documentary for anybody that is a big fan of Paul Butterfield. There's a great documentary out there called Horn from the Heart, and it's a fantastic, fantastic movie. And I just saw on Facebook last year, because they were only doing movie screenings at the time, but now they released it digitally, you know, for the public. So you can find it on DVD and Blu-ray through Amazon. You can stream it on Amazon Prime Music, or Prime Video, I should say, iTunes, Google Play, YouTube, Microsoft, Vimeo, and Vudu. If you have not watched this documentary, I definitely recommend checking it out. It is such a fantastic documentary. And you know, someone else who's in the studio with us who did watch the movie, Pat, what did you think of Horn from the Heart when you first saw it?
Well, I loved it, but what was cracking me up is before they let us into the theater, we were in back where everyone was milling around. I didn't know John at the time, but you were at that screening that was in down there by the beach.
Fashion Island.
Fashion Island, yeah. There you were.
I met the producer that day, and I've seen that thing at least 5 or 6 times. And in fact, I actually helped do some promotion out here for that thing.
And
it's something, I'll tell you.
The producer and John, the cameraman.
Yeah, John Anderson, yeah.
Yeah, and who was the girl's name again?
Sandy Warren.
Yeah, I interviewed them here at our studio for that horn from the Harp.
Yeah, I listened to it. That was great.
Thank you very much. It was a phone interview, but it went down really, really nice, and I enjoyed doing that. And so it's funny you asked that, Robert, because he was there.
That's a good call. I to this day, I mean, I got to thank them for doing that, because, you know, that's one of the most meaningful music things, like, in the last 20 years for me, was seeing that. And boy, did that bring back memories, I'll tell you.
And it always seemed like to me, like, Butterfield's story, before they made this documentary, Butterfield's story was just kind of looked over. Paul seemed so underrated as compared to guys like Sonny Boy Williamson and Little Walter and, you know, everybody whose stories have been told millions of times. But this was the first time that Paul became the spotlight for his story to be told. And if you haven't seen that documentary, definitely go check it out. You pretty much got three reviews right here. Yeah, 3 5-star reviews right here.
And you know what was neat, Robert? There was a number of people that were in that band or bands that Paul was part of that were in the audience.
Yeah, they had a round table, and Buzz Featon, the great Buzz Featon, was there. And Steve Madeo, the great trumpet player who passed recently.
Oh, did he?
Yeah, he was a good friend of Cal David's out in the desert.
Cal David, what a guitarist.
Yeah, no kidding.
We could talk about him for a while,
oh,
too.
Oh, yeah, one of my favorites. And you know, how many great guitar players in the world can sing like that guy?
And he's so...
He's so good.
He's so people friendly.
Yeah.
I like to share a story. I was with my in-laws in Palm Springs one evening, 5, 10, 15 years ago, and my brother-in-law says, "Hey, they got a blues club here. It's called the Blue Guitar. You want to go?" Heck yeah. And we went, and I think he had a 3-piece band, and those cats, and Lori was there too. And boy, what a fun evening it was. And he'd take a break, and he'd stand in the back, and his fans would come up and talk to him about this and about that. Then he'd get back to it, and really had a good evening.
They're incredible. He plays at this place called Vicky's now every Saturday during the season, and he's got a really good keyboardist, you know, that does the keyboard, bass, and his drummer is amazing too. And they're just, it's like, I mean, you know, you could spend what, $1,000 to go see Eric Clapton at some, in the Rose Bowl or something, or you could go to Vicky's and hear somebody that's every bit as good.
You're
for
right.
free.
But the reason why I bring up Paul Butterfield is, not only was he a big influence to you, but on the Golden Butter Revue album, you guys actually do a really good version of Born in Chicago. And so we're going to go into Born in Chicago, and we are going to talk more about your story, John. But I've also got a Paul Butterfield track and a couple of Mike Bloomfield tracks, because Mike Bloomfield was a big part of Butterfield's band at that time too.
No, he's the one that drew me to the Butterfield Blues Band in the first place. Just hearing that guitar he's one of my favorites also.
So we're going to go into Born in Chicago from the Golden Butter Revue's Cookin' at the Harp album, and then the next three songs you're going to hear are from the Paul Butterfield Blues Band and Michael Bloomfield. You keep it right here on your favorite blues station, Pat. We are 22 West Radio at
22westmedia.com.
I was born in Chicago. just don't seem the same.
All right, Rick Roll.
Now my heart is getting heavy. I've lost my appetite. Heart is getting heavy. Lost my appetite. You know, Blue Devil worked me over in my dreams that night. It's been too long, yeah, set in my lonesome cell. It's been too long, yeah, I've sat in my lonesome cell. Now the state is going to kill me and send my soul to hell. They call it murder. It was a matter of pride. They call it murder. It was a matter of pride. And I saw that roundup with my woman by his side. Now don't want anybody to step on, and the priest he just now come. Now I don't want anybody to step on, and the priest just now come. I hear death bell tolling, I believe my time had come. Here's my last go round. Yeah, have mercy on my soul. I believe I'm sinking down.
And finishing off that set of music was Michael Bloomfield with Death Cell Rounder Blues from If You Love These Blues, Play Them As You Please. And we kicked it off with the Golden Butter Review, Born in Chicago, from their brand new album, Cookin' at the Harp. In the last break, we talked a lot about Paul Butterfield, and you even mentioned Michael Bloomfield was kind of who got you into the Butterfield Blues Band because of his integral guitar playing, just as well as Elvin Bishop as well. Looking at the songs here, how did you come about this lineup of tracks for the album?
You know, they just are, some of them are songs that we've been doing for years, John Burton and me, and some of them are new ones. There's not really a pattern to it, although we try to give people enough familiar material that they're not lost when they come and see us. But we also want them to hear stuff that they've never heard before. And the other thing is we love to play music that people like to dance to. But, you know, not all of our songs are that way. So I don't know. It's just, and in fact, I never attempted Driftin' and Driftin' until about a year ago. And, you know, that was my favorite song in high school, the Butterfield version of that. I just thought it was the greatest thing, but maybe it was out of reverence. Maybe I didn't think we could pull it off, but we came up with a version of it, and I put some, a multiple break ending at the end of it, and we got all the punches really sounding good. So, and in fact, the version on there is, that might be the first time we ever played that song, and Mark Sells plays the last guitar solo, and I said, Mark, whatever you guys do, keep the intensity up at the end, just keep blazing, and he got the message, and he's like powering right through it, and it's, I don't know, it's hard to explain. Some are new and some are old.
Well, and one of the songs on here that was one of the first tracks that you sent me and Pat that I dug so well because of like you say, that that factor of wanting to get the crowd dancing a little bit, was Riot in Cell Block Number 9. That's a great tune. And when you sent me that track, that's the first time I've ever heard that song. I had never even knew that song existed.
Our version is, it was kind of drawn from Commander Cody and Bill Kirchen. Mm-hmm. I saw them do that at Don the Beachcomber a couple years ago when it was still open. And I found myself singing, there's a riot going on. Yeah, I it's infectious. I couldn't help it. So,
right.
So that's where that came from.
Now, of course, the album is officially out, correct?
It's out, yes.
But this weekend, you guys are having your CD release party. Would you like to tell everybody where they can pick up a copy of it?
Well, I'm still working on how to... the interest in this CD has been really surprising to me, and it must be because of the videos and stuff. The videos that we do and the audio from these songs in most cases are one and the same. Mm-hmm. So they get an idea of what we really sound like, either from the videos or the CD. I mean, this is so let's say you go to one of our shows and you like it, then why not take a CD home of this, what you just heard, rather than some studio thing that's mm-hmm. might not even have the same guys on it or whatever. You know, the intention of it was just to have a demo for getting, you know, like into festivals and, you know, higher profile gigs and stuff. I mean, and then it turned out, you know, we have an album here. The CD release party is at the Harp Inn in Costa Mesa on 17th Street. And we're going to play from about 3:30 to 7 this coming Sunday, January 12th. And we have a host of really talented guests that are going to join us. The first set is just going to be Golden Butter Revue only. And then from that point on, we'll work some of these special guests into the songs.
And both Pat and I hope to be there on Sunday to come check you guys out and check out the Golden Butter Revue this Sunday at the Harp Inn in Costa Mesa. Pat and I hope to be there. Stop on by and say hi. Pat, would you like to say something?
Yeah, I would like to say something. First of all, I'm really excited that... you've selected our station and that Robert has extended the invitation to you to come here and be a guest. This is what I consider a CD release radio show, and you've selected us. This is a worldwide exclusive. No other radio station in the world has had you in to help promote this, so it's a really a good feeling. And once again, we are Robert is trying to spin as many tunes off your brand new album. It's called Cookin' at the Harp, And again, it's a worldwide exclusive brought to you by Robert Eliff and 22 West Radio. And thank you very much, John, for being here.
I'm kind of blown away by being here. The fact that you guys think enough of me and our music to have me in here, it means a lot. So I really appreciate it. I can't thank you enough.
And we thank you for being here. Thank you very much.
Well, coming up, we're going to kick off the next block of music with actually a Nick Gravenitis tune, because this goes into one of the other songs that's on the Golden Butter Revue CD, which the track that I'm going to play after this Nick Gravenitis tune is Buried Alive in the Blues, which Nick wrote. But we're going to play something from Nick's My Labor's album, which is one that you sent me, called Killing My Love, featuring Michael Bloomfield on the guitar. John, anything you want to say before we get to it?
You know, we all have our opinions about music, and I tend to be given to superlatives at times. I was a music critic in college, and I have pretty strong opinions. This song has my all-time favorite blues guitar solo on it. And not only that, the music from My Labors with Nick, and how beautifully it was recorded, it just everything came together. And it's really a shame, like, casual Bloomfield fans, you know, they all think of Super Session and all this. Well, just have a listen to this one and tell me if you like it, because I sure do.
Well, here's Nick Gravenitis with Killing My Loves from My Labor's album. You keep it right here on your favorite blues station. We are 22 West Radio at
22westmedia.com.
Killing my love, Lord, every way. And if you succeed, Lord, it's gonna haunt you till the dying day. A lover is a person knows how to
you deserve, baby. Later on down the line, you'll kill my love. Lost every way. And if you succeed,